that a little closer. See the point of separation there. Just wanted to get a half decent little grind in there so that my weld's going to penetrate pretty good. We'll get the welder. If you listen real quiet, you can hear the birds chirping. Well, it's time to get my weld on. Get my auto darkening helmet on and kick the power and the welder on. Make sure my path is clear so I've got room to work. And let's get this sucker welded. Got spiders in my helmet. My current is not high enough. Am I on low? Yes, I'm on low. Let's show you guys. I've got a gumball weld here, so I'm gonna pause the camera, cut that or grind that off because I know I didn't get any penetration, and then I'll be right back. Didn't even think to look. Okay, now let's try to weld now that we have the welder set the correct way. I always carry a set of nippers close by the welder so that I can nip my length off. Alright, and I'm left-handed, but living in a right-handed world, you learn how to compensate and do things. I guess I call myself ambidextrous, but we got to weld this one right-handed for a little bit, right back around here, and then we will switch back over to the left hand when we get to the back side. Hang on, we're welding. Wire brush that real quick, see what it looks like. Not too bad, considering it's a cheapy Harbor Freight welder, not too much spatter. Now I'm getting down towards the end of my spool, so every 30 seconds of welding or so, I've got to loosen up the spool a little bit and unbind the remaining wire on the spool. There's probably still 20 feet or so on it, but you know, you get the Harbor Freight welder, and you get the Harbor Freight welding wire, flux core welding wire. You kind of got to do what you got to do. All right. Let's get finished going around this here. And we're off. Burning off a little bit of the powder coat. That smells yummy. Yeah, where's my ventilation? See, I don't claim to be the best welder in the world, but that's gonna hold. They say a welder doesn't need a grinder. I'm just wire brushing, and I tend to agree. If you can lay down a decent enough weld that you look at it and it doesn't look like ass, then, you know, I call that good enough. Now we're going to go around this side. There isn't anything that'll get in the way. We're going to go around this side and weld the entire thing. So you guys really don't need to watch that. Nothing but a bunch of welding going on. After I get done, we'll throw her back together, see what we've got for steering. So sit tight. Well, I've seen worse welds. It's in there good enough. Got it all the way around. For a cheap little $90 welder, I'm not gonna complain. It did pretty good. Let's get her together. Well, we got her back on and she's moving the way she needs to move. All we gotta do now is just get this tightened up and we will be, hopefully, off and running to the races with no steering issues. Now, you can only weld on one side of those because mating surface up here, obviously you can't weld on from the bottom side, so that's why I didn't weld there. The weld is all the way around this base here, so we should be golden. Now all we have to do is stick the tire on, get the clip on, let her down, take her out, give her a test roll around, see how she does. I mean, I know it's going to be fine, but you always got to show the end result, right? These are some tight clips. Almost. A little more. There you go. Can't forget the grease cap. Gotta have the grease cap. We'll throw some grease in that spindle. And yeah, I like these grease caps, but they're not. Yep, there goes the phone. I was gonna say we got through this entire little series without the phone going off, but I can't say that now, can I? I could be less than rude, put my phone on silent, but then I wouldn't know if somebody needs me for something. All right. I'll get that grease cap on. There's no sense you guys sitting here watching that. We'll get it on the ground, take it out, see how she does. Oh yeah, it's hot. My gloves are smoking. See how pliable that is now? I just heated it up a little bit with a torch. Now it should just slip, pop right on. There we go. Alright, well, I guess you can call that a quick tip. Get those covers back on, just heat them up a little bit. Heat gun or something. And you'll get them back on. So, let's see what we got. Be back.